What's up, YouTube? It's your boy T with a message. I don't do no peace sign. Let's get it. Go ahead and wait a minute. I think I should introduce my boys first. You already know who this guy is.
You already know who this guy is.
All right, man.
G, aka Jeff.
Okay, let's get that out of the way. He's my new boy over here. He's not
Mark, yeah.
Okay, let's keep it like that. Okay, we're gonna watch a trailer of The Swamp Thing, okay? He's a heavily DC fan, even though we have the Marvel in the background. Don't let that fool you. This guy is a DC dick rider.
All the way, man. All the way. Yeah.
Okay, but enough said. Let's get into the video, okay? Like the message. If you like the message, tell a friend to tell a friend. That being said, let's get into the video.
This sample is unlike anything I've ever seen before.
Is quite limited.
Dr. Arcane. Abby Arcane.
5,000 people work at the CDC. That's 4,999 other options they could have sent.
There is all kinds of awful that happens in this swamp, but I think you'd know that.
She was like my sister. I killed her.
All that darkness wasn't my fault. It was yours.
Something's out there.
Okay, what do you guys think though? Because honestly, I feel grossed out, but at the same time, I want to watch, but I don't want to watch. You get what I'm saying?
It's gross, but it's the
shit. Yeah, it looks sick though. I'm not getting you wrong that it's sick or nothing like that. I'm just saying, like, I feel like I should watch it, but I feel also like I should not watch it alone.
You feel disgusted by the way.
I mean, I should not watch it alone because honestly, this is something you're supposed to watch with people.
Because you're sick and scary at the same time.
This is one of those things that doesn't make it horror. Is he even a superhero?
He is kind of.
Because DC is like making most of the shows.
He's a man. They captured my interest. I'm watching it. I'm just waiting, bro.
But I don't know.
It looks gross, but I'm just it's the Swamp Thing, though. Like you should expect that, you know.
Yeah.
Cause it's the Swamp Thing, bro. It's the Swamp Thing.
That's what you gotta say. I gotta let you guys know right now. I am not a big fan of something that's horrible or anything that has to do with horrors. As of this time of my livelihood, I'm not saying that I'm scared or I'm like a little kid or nothing like that. I'm just saying. When Nightmare comes crawling, I'm not going to be the one that's going to be under the bed. I'm going to be the one on top of it. You know, I'm not going to be that guy that's going to be like, but yo, it looks interesting. I think you guys should, when it comes out, go check out The Swamp Thing. Tell us what you think. Leave your comment on the comment section below. If you're hating, go ahead and hate below that. If you're liking, go ahead and like it and tell a friend to like it. The message is received. I like you and you like me. If you like me and I like you, that means you should make me.
By the way, did he say it's going to be on like the DC streaming service?
Yeah, August.
Oh, so, they're doing that thing.
Yeah.
Oh,
so they officially like came up with their own streaming service.
They
just announced it last year. So they officially opened it.
So they're gonna put Doom Patrol and stuff like that in there.
No, but like what I think is what they're doing, they're just like giving you all these little things. They're gonna make sure that like they have their
own in the same
platform.
Place. Mm-hmm. So, like it makes sense. Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
Because at the end of the day, what's the point of them like making all these movies and TV shows if they're not gonna have like credits for all?
Yeah,
them.
Exactly. Like you know? Like your own.
It's competition out here.
Yeah.
You know, everybody's trying to get it. DC is getting it. Disney is getting it, and also Netflix been on it. So. All those other streaming everybody's just trying to get
out. So, I think when I put all the DC movie, TV show, cartoons, comics, all in that like streaming service,
hopefully,
all
that, that would be nice.
It would make a lot of sense if they bring everything, the all ones, all there. Like,
But honestly, though, like what they're doing, though,
Do
you guys see what they're doing? What is kind of like messed up is that they're trying to get viewers so they can catch the people's attention, but that's not, they should not go over that route. The route they should take is that get all your old TV shows, all your old movies, put them in all sections and stuff, and then get new TV shows and movies and put them in that a section where everybody's gonna go see it. Because if you don't do that, you actually automatically lose. Because if you do like what I'm telling you right now, I don't know, maybe you guys don't do it, not do it, but it'd be the same thing with Disney, you know? If Disney comes out, and this is what I think is gonna happen with the streaming world, if it comes out and they bring out all the old Disney TV shows, all the old Disney movies, and they bring in all the new Disney movies and all the ones that they have labels on, bang, this right there, you win.
Definitely.
You win, because like you're gonna have the old fans, and then you're gonna have the new fans
as well.
And then now you're gonna have the people that are in between, they'll be like, should I go check it out? And when they go check it out, they're like, we have varieties, we have a place for us to go, and that's what they should be doing. But instead, but even like you looking at something right now, what does it make you think of?
Like in what sense?
And when you're watching a superhero movie or a TV show, what are you getting off it?
I mean, I feel like it's different. In a most superhero movie, like you get like he's always like good.
Mm-hmm.
It feels like he's a bit bad in a way, but then he might turn around and do some good stuff as well. That's what I think.
Yeah.
Just looking at the trailer, because
like the trailer, it looks like he's gonna be like anti-hero,
like a Deadpool character, something like that.
Yeah.
So that's what I'm trying to get from you guys. What I'm trying to say is, when I look at what they're doing with DC, right, with their TV shows now, I'm getting a vibe of what Marvel's doing with their TV shows, where they are trying to get the character around it off the bat. You know, when they're trying to like make sure that all the character. And don't get me wrong, you know, DC had a lot of great TV shows that actually showed, we'll call it, emotions and how to be connective and to connect with people before you can even know the powers, you know? But when it comes to Marvel, I think that's where, like, if you're actually watching Marvel, you're like, Jessica Jones, Luke Cage, where they shine is not where their superpowers are. They shine from where...
Interactions.
Yeah.
Especially, you know, Luke Cage, like the way they captured the whole black, you know, community and stuff.
Mm.
It was... Yeah, amazing stuff.
Yeah. So it's just, I think like with the Swamp Thing, or even like with Batman, or like Titans. I mean, Titans.
Yeah, Titans.
Same thing. Which was.
Man, I don't know. Titans was a disappointment.
Come on, man. Honestly, like I expected better, but it was a good startup, you know.
Hopefully, season two they'll bring that A game. But honestly, I was disappointed, man. Watching the cartoon.
I know.
And honestly, when you can't compare cartoon and
it's hard.
It's always gonna be hard, like to top up, like
because like you know DC has like amazing animation movies, but then you get to the actual movies and
like live action when it comes to DC was like the powers you can really tell about, okay, that is Flash, that's definitely how the Flash is supposed to be moving.
Mm-hmm.
That's definitely how Supergirl is supposed to be moving. But then where they lack sometimes, that's my opinion, you guys can hate it, is where I want the emotions to come up. And I know you guys are gonna be like, oh my god, this guy is trying to get emotions. Is he emotional? We're all emotional. You're emotional, and you're watching this video because you're an emotional little prick. And I don't think that. I believe that. And that's my opinion. That's my opinion. This could hurt you. But it's my opinion at the end of the day. An opinion that does not really, should not matter, but it does matter because you're watching, so. My message I'm trying to tell you guys is that you have an opinion and you should speak up your mind so we can hear your opinion. So we could hate it or we can like it. Or at the end of the day, if you put an opinion out there, at least somebody can listen to something or we can connect somehow.
Yeah.
So. Swamp Thing, what do you think about it? Is it something you want to go watch? Something you want to not watch? I suggest you go watch it and find out. But.
Yeah, because if you don't watch it, you won't find out whether you like it or hate it. So what I'll say is go check it out yourself. It's coming, I don't know, like
October 31st, like yeah? That's what it says. October 31st.
Yeah, something like that. So go check it out and let us know how you feel about it, you know? Mm-hmm. Leave your comments below and go down there, like it, subscribe.
Yeah, but honestly though, I can't wait for this generation going forward, because with all the things that are going on right now, y'all should be lucky to be alive at this point in time, because a lot of good things are gonna happen and a lot of bad things are gonna happen, and if you're there to witness it, that's history. All right, remember what they always say. Remember what I always say. I don't do the peace sign. One, we always doing this.
Until then, next time.
Power to the people, man. Let's go.
Boy, you in these streets, better look left and right. Cause them niggas out here killing it, take your life.
Take your life.
Nigga killed him, now he out of mind, out of sight. So the game better focus, boy, ain't no losing sight. Throw them in the kitchen with the Caroline.